Good morning and praise the Lord. It's, pardon me, I had to get that last sip of that great cup of coffee. Now, let's get this party started. I want to say good morning and God bless each and every one of you. This is the day that the Lord has made and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. For those of you who do not know, this is Pastor Sadie Thompson, co-pastor of He Is Risen World Outreach Ministries, and we are located in the beautiful city of Lafayette, Louisiana. And I hope and I pray that each and every one of you, under the sound of my voice, had a wonderful, wonderful resurrecting weekend. But this is my prayer, this is my desire, that you don't just celebrate the risen Savior on one day out of the year, but you celebrate the risen Savior, the born again experience, 365 days in a year, or 366, because that was the essence of this magazine to be called Rise Again. Rise up from whence you came, out of the ashes of doubt, fear, and unbelief, and know that God has something great just for you. Now, I want to get to my beautiful guest, as you can see to my right. That's gospel recording artist Betty Hawkins, and the name of her group is Betty Hawkins and United. Now, what I'm loving about this picture is she looks so carefree, like I don't have a care in the world. Hey, glory. I need to start getting that same pose and hold my head up and tilt it to the side and see if I can carry that look, because it looks mighty good on you, my sister. Good morning and God bless you, Sister Betty.
Good morning. How are you out there
in
Lafayette, Louisiana?
We waiting on us some Betty Hawkins in the United. We're gonna start a group. We want Betty. We want Betty. Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Now look at here. I'm just happy today. I'm happy, first of all, that I'm alive. Thank you, Jesus. And I mean that sincerely, because I did not have to be here. But it was his finger of love who woke me up, and I want to acknowledge that. And then the second thing is, I've had the privilege of being in a quote-unquote service where this gifted vessel worked it. I mean to tell you, she grabbed that mic with her singers and just allowed the Lord to use her to bring forth deliverance of fear and depression, and just release the presence of God in the room with joy and great expectation. Now, I know y'all said, when is this happening? When did it happen? It did happen. Let me make that perfectly clear. But you can get that same experience, that one-on-one intimacy, by pulling her up on the YouTube and looking for the gospel artist, Betty Hawkins and United. You're going to get a treat. I just want to throw that out there, first of all, because when we start talking, I don't want them to get lost in the shuffle. So I wasn't able to download that today, and I apologize. Forgive me, my sister. I wasn't able to for time restraints. But I really want my listening audience to go there to YouTube and find you and enjoy your music. Now, got all our business out of the way. Let's talk. Can we talk? Can we just talk?
We can talk.
Thank you. Thank you. I told you I'm feeling pretty silly today, so you just have to work with me, okay? Just pray for me in the interim, as my teacher would say, Sadie, can you just breathe? Can you just breathe? Please breathe before you say something. There you go. So look at here. Listen. How did you get from A? I'm not going to say the Z, because you're not there yet. You're ready to go to the next level. But how did you fall in love with gospel music? Or did God bring you to the music? Or did the music bring you to God? That's a twofold question, So I'm going to sit back, and I'm going to be quiet and listen.
Praise God. First of all, I'm in love with music. I love music. But, you know, with all of us, we all have a certain type of music that we're pulled to.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be gospel music.
Come on.
Now, I did start out. I was a youngster. I was singing in, let's say, talent shows and different things that we were having around the school.
Mm-hmm.
And I would sing, you know, ballads from Natalie Cole and different artists.
What you know about that? You was a young girl. What you know about that? Praise God. Look what he's doing. It is marvelous.
That's God's work.
Yeah.
But I did ballads from, like, you know, artists like Natalie Cole and Rita Franklin. And,
okay.
I sung those when I was coming up in school. But as time went on, I was just pulled more to the gospel music.
Thank you, Jesus.
I was gospel music.
Yeah.
You know, like, especially Tremaine Hawkins. Love
Tremaine Hawkins. Yeah, I could see that.
I sing a lot of her songs. Yes, I did. I love Tremaine Hawkins her songs, and I was just inspired by a lot of those songs that she sang.
Mm-hmm.
Walter Hawkins and the Love Center Choir.
Right, right.
And so I started out singing, you know, different types of music, and after a while, you know, God won, of course.
You got drug on the Lord's side? Was you drug?
Yeah, so, you know, I'm not comfortable, you know, like some people are just straddling the fence over here and over there. So I made a choice, and I chose to come over.
Wait a minute, hold up. Pump your brakes. I have to interfere. I said I was going to be quiet, but that bears repeating because I'm hearing something there, and I need you to help me there. Could you repeat that phrase again? You didn't feel comfortable straddling the fence?
Yes, ma'am. I didn't feel comfortable. Now, it's okay every now and then. Like, somebody asked me to sing at a wedding.
Mm-hmm.
Everything has its place and season.
Of course.
So I'll sing a song at a wedding, but just out here singing, I'm going to sing blues, you know, and, you know, world music over here. And then on Sunday morning, Saturday night, I'm going to do the world music. And then on Sunday morning, I'm going to get up and I'm going to try to get on the praise and worship and sing for God. It just don't work for me. That don't work for me. I can't do that.
Mm.
I'm not comfortable with straddling the fence. You need to choose which side you want to be on.
Mm.
Because I'm not real comfortable gap leg like that.
Ooh.
I got to get on one side or the other.
Girl, you can't.
And that's just how I feel about that. Those are my thoughts.
Go ahead. You thinking good. You thinking good because that's the scripture. It says, how can bitter water and sweet water come out the same fountain? So you good?
Yeah, it can. So at some point, you know, the word says you choose.
Okay.
When you're going to serve.
Uh-huh.
And I just choose to serve God. And I choose to sing godly music.
Okay.
You know? Some of my songs, some people like say, well, they don't sound all that churchy.
What does that mean? Is that a new phenomenon, churchy, that it's not in a particular A-shaped building? What does that mean? I'm serious, because I'm a big thing about words and what they mean. So what does that mean?
I'm still trying to figure that one out.
See, okay, I was just asking.
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure that one out, but music, when I sing, I'm trying to reach people.
Yeah.
I'm trying to reach people's situations.
Jesus.
I'm trying to reach their hearts. I'm trying to reach where they are at that point, where they are at that moment in their life.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have time to be concerned about if something is what you call churchy.
Come on.
First of all, everybody's not going to go into church.
Thank you. And you're supposed to have it in you. The location doesn't make the church. You're supposed to bring Jesus when you show up. He lives in you. So, well, I'm just saying, if you say.
Well, you're saying right.
I'm just saying. Like the song say, heaven belongs to you if you live right.
It belongs to you. right.
I'm just saying, Girl.
Yes.
Oh my goodness gracious. But to be fair and not to be so dogmatic, because I don't want to come across as being, as they love to say down here, sassy, blunt.
Okay.
Whatever else they be saying, I don't know. But this is the point, and I do understand the connotation that she meant, at least I think I do, but I don't want to admit it. It's this. She's looking for a particular experience that she experienced, and it didn't match up with what she thinks is what belongs in the church. But she missed the whole essence of what God said. He come to save a dying generation. He didn't come to save them that say that they saved. He come to save the dying generation.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
And you're meeting the people right where they are. That's the difference. I love what you said. You're not, so in other words, and don't get me wrong, everybody deserves, you don't nuzzle the ox, you're supposed to feed him. So you are supposed to, if you're making records, if you are ministering, you are supposed to be receive donations in regards to that. But your main concern is the state that you left the people in. That they didn't come in and left the same way. They wasn't dry clean.
Amen.
They got what they needed from God. They got a sure God encounter.
Amen. Amen. It's true. That's so true.
How does that happen? How can you recreate that?
How can you recreate? Can you be a little bit more specific?
Okay, what I'm trying to say is, you know, I'm pretty sure because, you know, people don't, ideas are not like original. So if somebody, I'm sure there is somebody that's out there that's trying to imitate you and your style, because your style is very unique. You are an authentic singer. You have a mixture of this and a mixture of that, the vibe that they feel, but that ushers them into the presence of God. So if somebody's trying to mimic you, or like there's a singer, and I don't want to give her name, who sounds similar to Aretha Franklin. If you were to hear Aretha Franklin's record and you hear her record, there wouldn't be too much difference. But then as she was to go on and sing a little bit further, you would feel the difference on the type of the music. Like there was a man, there's a story that is an old man who there was a young man, preacher, who gave an eloquent speech about the 23rd Psalms. People clapped, but there was an older man who got up and began to quote it with such conviction and such, he owned it because this is something that he did every day. This was his daily prayer. And the people began to weep and to cry because the difference was the anointing and the relationship that man had with God versus someone giving an elegant speech. That's what I mean.
Right, right.
For that person to be able to try to emulate you, and then it gets lost in the shuffle. It's not the same.
It's not the same. It's
not the same.
It's funny that I was speaking to my brother yesterday.
Okay.
And he was telling me, he said, my children are singing one of your songs. And I said, praise God.
Mm-hmm.
By that. And he says that they're singing your song. And so I began to see something in my mind, a seed being planted.
Yeah.
Seeds are planted.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't really matter if someone is trying to emulate me.
Mm-hmm.
It's my job to plant the seed.
Okay.
Someone else comes along and waters.
Yeah.
God's gonna give the increase.
Mm-hmm.
And he's gonna give the increase according to the heart of that person.
Yes.
What you're going to do with that seed that was planted and watered. Now, it's up to me what I do now.
Yes, yes,
I love Tremaine Hawkins, but I'm no Tremaine Hawkins. I love all the other ministers of music that came before me. But God gave them a vision at that time.
Yes.
And God has given me a vision at this particular time.
Yes.
And I can only run with what God gives me.
Come on.
It's for this season.
Come on.
What they did was for that season.
Yeah.
Now I'm in this season, because really, be honest, I started out singing a different type of music. I was more into the, I did a lot of traditional gospel stuff, And I noticed that God, after I had this conversation with them, God has transformed and did something different with me with the music. It's a lot different than I thought.
Uh-huh.
And I was talking to a woman of God. We were speaking, and she said, what God is doing for you in this season is he has an audience just for you.
Yes, indeed. Count me in. I'm in on it. Count me in. I'm down with that. And again, it comes back to the sound. Because he's looking for a particular sound in the atmosphere. And I don't want to equate it to this, but I want to give the illustration as, you know those whistles that dog trainers use? It's such a high pitch that the average person can't hear it. But the animal that he's training or the animal that he's having a relationship with, he can hear it.
All right, you better come on now.
And it's, it's sort of equated to the same thing that by my sheep heareth my voice.
My voice.
And none other will they answer to. But in order to do the answering, you got to be free. You can't come with your, you know, Jesus only works like this. We're going to sing two songs, one prayer, one offering, 30-minute sermon, and it's time to go. I got football. I got dinner. We got to go. My daddy cracked me up before he got saved, because he wasn't saved all his natural little life, nor was I. But he cracked me up. It don't take all day to serve God, daughter. And I'd be like, Daddy, we need to be there all day.
Okay.
Because we're so jacked up.
Yeah, we got a lot of stuff going on.
So we need to go. This is what he's trying to like. Could you come on? Could you hurry it up a little bit? But all joking aside, what I was alluding to was, it's your relationship with God that makes the difference. That's why no matter how much they sing like you, you know, pause, do the riffs. I don't know all the musical terms. I'm not going to try to fool you and tell you that I know. I don't. I'm in Sunday school, in young people's choir, I mess up a song. The words I didn't know, I just put some in there and they just flowed. That's all I'll just say. I've been paraphrasing all my life.
Working by you.
It sure has been so far. Help me, Jesus, help me. So the point that I was trying to make is this. It's your relationship with God, and that cannot be duplicated. No matter how hard they try. Praise God.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God. Yeah.
And I've gone through a lot of things, and it's building relationships. I have relationship, but relationship continues to build, because we have these up and down moments, even in our relationships with our husbands and wives. We have up and down moments. So we're constantly always working on and building relationships.
So is this another show that you ready to open up and come back next week we can talk about? I hear another show in the atmosphere.
I hear it.
So this up and down phenomenal. I'm going to put it like that. This thing called being a human being, and this situation of trying to understand and to be an effective communicator. All of this, it takes work. It takes time. Even when you don't want to, you still got to show up. You got to show up. You got to. And so you're telling me that your relationship with God, it has grown deeper. Is this what you're saying, alluded to? Or did you saying you're hot, you're cold, you're lukewarm? I don't want to put words in your mouth. Could you just spread that out a little bit easier for me?
I won't say hot and cold, lukewarm, all that stuff. But, you know, what I'm saying is basically what I'm really saying. Good. You're in relationship with God. But I've gone through some things, which some people, when they go through some stuff, because some people think they're not supposed to go into anything. Once they got a relationship with God, everything is just happy-go-lucky, great things going to happen. No, that's not reality. We're on the earth here. Come on back down.
They didn't read the small print. They didn't. No, because I didn't. No.
Okay.
No, I didn't know there was small print. But I found out.
Read it.
I found out.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're always working on that. And all the stuff that I've gone through, some people would have walked away from God. Mm-hmm. But it drew me close. I've gotten closer to God. And I'm always looking for that closeness in everything that happens. I'm always looking. I go into the Word for it, because that's my roadmap. That's just my roadmap. You don't want to, nowadays they don't want to get on the road unless they got a GPS system. Well, that's the way I am with life. I don't want to be in this life without my GPS system, which is God.
Come on.
Yes, Lord. Amen. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm in relationship with him and all the stuff that I've gone through. And that's my songs, they reflect some of the stuff that I've gone through and gotten to that place, you know. Where
okay, so since we're talking about stuff you've been gone through, and just in case I don't get to the YouTube today, so you want to help a sister out and break a couple of them down, like rejection, or what are we talking about here?
I wrote all the songs, all of my songs.
Come on. Awesome.
Yes, I wrote them all. Yes. Praise God.
Amen.
And I wrote this song. Go ahead. I wrote this song called You Are, which I say when You Are is what I call acknowledgement of who God is in my life.
Mm-hmm.
It's all of his attributes. It spells out all his attributes. And, you know, I left some off, you know, but with you may add some things because, you know, it's really, I call it the dot, dot, dot. Fill in the blank.
Yeah, I like that. I like that.
And so you are reflecting acknowledgement. And then I have a phone call, All I Need. That, since we're talking about resurrection, mm-hmm. Sunday, let's talk about All I Need. All I Need, it's a testimony about my niece who died. She was resurrected.
What?
She was resurrected. She stopped breathing and was resurrected. Yes. And I wish I had time to really tell you that.
You do. We got 30 minutes. I'm listening. This is my show. I'm listening. Go ahead.
Okay.
We got time. I'll tell you when. I'll slow your roll. Go ahead. We got time. We're going to make time.
I'm not going to call any names and tell you, because some people might know exactly who the person is. But
no, but niece is fine.
She's quite well known.
Okay.
It's my nephew, and it was his daughter, and she was at home with him, and I'm going to make a long story short, she stopped breathing, and, you know, he kind of panicked, you know what I mean, some men, they panic, some men know exactly what to do, but this man panicked, and she stopped breathing, he just got to, he's like around the corner from his mom, he put the baby, these both babies in the car, took it to his mom, she's a nurse, and she wasn't breathing, so he hollered out, I'm telling you, he was sick. Frantic, he's throwing up. So he started, I guess he caught himself, he started thinking about God. And he called out Jesus three times. And when he got to the third time, she started breathing.
Mm-hmm.
The ambulance was still already on the way, and she started breathing. And when we all ran to the hospital, we all went up there, and it was something to encounter. And I remember coming home. I was standing in the mirror, and I said, God, your love is a continual experience.
Mm-hmm.
You are all that we need.
Mm.
And that is the chorus of the song.
Mm-hmm.
I just get a paper and write that down. All I need, your love is a continual experience.
Mm-hmm.
And that, when you hear the song, you'll understand the song. Because he did say, seek ye first the kingdom of heaven and all of its righteousness,
mm-hmm.
and everything else shall be added. So if I have him, I have all I need.
Mm.
That's resurrection power, food, clothing, regulation of mind. Everything I need is in God, and that's where all I need comes from.
Mm.
Then I have a song called Faith for God, and that's talking about my relationship with God.
Okay.
And then there's a song called A Change is Coming. That's my personal testimony. And actually, it's something because God had me write that song when I had a daughter that passed away recently, mm-hmm. and about a year ago.
I'm so sorry
and,
for your loss.
She was part of the group.
Mm.
I'm sorry.
I said, I'm so sorry.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And she was part of the group. But I was here getting ready for church. And we have church at 9 o'clock in the morning. And I'm getting ready for church, and these words just started coming. They were coming, too. I grabbed that paper and pen, and I started writing. And I was like, wow, God, it's a powerful song right here. And I put that song to the side for a while. And my daughter died. I dealt with the death of my daughter.
Mm.
It was after my daughter died. We done buried her and everything. The grief, we're going through the grief. We're still going through the grief. But anyway, that's another story.
It takes time.
I went back to practicing and started singing a song, and I broke.
Mm.
And I screamed, God, you had me write my testimony.
Mm.
And I wrote it before she ever died.
What?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
And that song talks about, I know it looks bad right now where you stand, but you must believe it's in God's plan. Those are some of the words in the song. And I got to singing that, and I was like, wow, oh my God, it hit me. God had me write my testimony. That's why the song was written and arranged in the same day, so quick.
For preparation.
Only before church, and arranged put the arrangement after church, same day. And that's why I know something God used. He's always up to something. Okay.
Let me ask you this. Let me ask you this, because that is so profound. And that is so like God. That's why he said, you know, he works in mysterious ways. So since this song was written before her death and then after her death, did you find solace in that song? Did you see the connection? You got it.
I got it. Yes, I got it. But it was for me, but it's also for other people.
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's for. As a matter of fact, since we're on that song,
mm-hmm.
let me tell you something. I was on Facebook one day, and you know, we were reading different posts and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I ran across this post where there was this person talking about not wanting to live anymore.
Mm.
I sent a link of A Change is Coming directly to that person's post because I need them to know that where they are right now is temporary.
Yes, indeed.
It's temporary.
Don't feel like it, but it is. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't do something permanent, you know, in this temporary moment. And that's when I knew, that's one thing I knew, that God, this song is not just for hundreds or thousands or millions of people, but it's for that one particular person that I can send it link to.
Mm.
And I know some people may say, well, hey, you're not going to make no money like that. Hey, this ministry.
What? I call that person Negative Nancy. Ain't nobody asked them all. Did you ask them about? Ain't nobody. I mean, that is so left field. I know they made a statement thinking that they're trying to help you or guard you, watch your money, but that was so unnecessary.
Well, everybody does not understand ministry.
Well, that part's true.
Yeah. So I just meet people wherever they are, you know.
You said you just leave them wherever they are? I be trying to figure out why I just get to meet them.
God, get to be patient. That's
right. Help me, Jesus.
Oh, wow.
Ooh-wee. Yes, indeed. He is taking you places with that. Wow. You kind of just blew the mind for a few minutes because I'm really wrapping my mind about that experience and how unique and how God that is, and how the healing. Have you had another song that would help with the healing, with the grief process? Have you cultivated that? That's still in the works.
Actually, the song "Amazing" it was just recently released.
Mm-hmm.
Now that song is a combination of all.
Come on. That makes sense.
It's a combination of, I guess you might say, the attributes of God.
Mm-hmm.
About the attributes of God, and then the relationship, and then in that song, there's a testimony part where I get to a testimony where I tell God, you brought me through my hurt. You've been a keeper in my pain.
Mm.
So it kind of gives you a combination of all of that.
Yeah, a climactic effect, yeah. And also a testimony of his greatness. And he is great.
And that he is. That he
is. And his wonder.
Oh,
life is a journey. We got to begin to enjoy the journey as we go along the way.
Oh, yes.
And
right.
Trying to quit taking the shortcuts. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
God has really taken me out of my comfort zone.
Yay! You're growing up! Yay! You're maturing! Yay!
Yes, I am.
Yay! Welcome to the club!
Okay!
Where dreams do come true.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, they do.
You take the bitter with the sweet. Yes, we have to take the bitter with the sweet.
Yeah, I don't want to be found in the class ever learning and never comprehending.
No, absolutely not.
I don't want to be found wanting, lacking, and back in class again.
I don't like taking tests. Over.
All right. I don't want to wear the little dunce cap. And God is so good, and He loves us so much. He doesn't care how old you are. You're going to repeat the class if you don't make it. So you can be 60, and the chair is way too little for you to sit in. You're going to sit right there until you complete the test.
Retaking those tests.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So let me get this right the first time.
Yeah. Who do I need to forgive? Sign me up.
Okay.
I forgive you. Love you. You know, what is it, Jimmy?
Out there, if I've offended you, forgive me. Because if you offended me, I have already forgiven you.
Yeah, so we can move on. Move forward in the glory and the goodness of God. And just to make you laugh, and then we're going to move along. It's sort of like the story of the little boy whose birthday was in July, and he received a sled. A snow sled, you know, to ride in the snow. And he says, oh, it's such a beautiful gift, but I really wished it was December right now, snowing. Not because he wanted to ride his sled, so he didn't care what month it was. He just wanted snow. just wanted snow so he can ride that slide. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. So, my sister, let me ask you this. Seems like you've been having an interesting life. I like the part about you talked about the, being saved, I always call it an adventure. Because you go in the store to buy some ice cream in the ice cream store, and you won 4 or 5 souls. You just went in there for ice cream.
That is so true.
But you end up winning 4 or 5 souls. Somebody said something, conversation went here and here and here, and God gets the glory, which is not a problem with that. I don't have a problem with none of that. But it seems like, have you thought about, or are you contemplating, it's time to write that book? I take my commission right now. My address is P.O. Box 2562, Opelousas, Louisiana. I'm sorry. You can read the small print. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Take it to me later.
I sure will. Just in case you don't re-look at the show, I sure will. So what? Now, tell me about the book you're getting ready to write. Or tell me about the book that you're procrastinating and you're going to get started so you won't have to repeat the class to write another book. So tell me about the book you are in the process of writing.
First of all,
let me put my seatbelt on.
Because before I start writing songs, I wrote down information on how to write a book. Stuff. I wrote the information. I have it in my binder. Information on writing a book. So when God tells me to take the next step, I'll take the next step.
Okay. So you're in preparation, but you've never seen the coalition of your songs as a book. You told me about the journey, how they got you there, but you've never seen that as a story or a storyline.
I can't say I haven't.
Oh, okay.
But I was speaking to a lady spoke to me, about a play.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not really, it's just in the talk mode. But she wanted to do a play based off of my life.
Okay, so it won't be necessarily a book. It will be a screenplay, and that's even better.
Yeah. We will see. We're going to see what God's going to take this thing. So.
Okay.
We'll leave it at that, right there.
So evidently, she better know how to.
I never say never, Pat.
Good, good. So you won't eat humble pie. But I can say this: if the person who plays you, if she can't sing, she better know how to lip sing good. She gonna be in trouble. I want to see this. I want front row seat. I want to be right when you sit. I want to be right on the, I won't be on the left or the right, but at least let me be no further than 2 rows back. I want to see all this.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. I want to see this. Yes, indeed. But you know, God is so good and he is so merciful. And until you're ready to receive the blessing, you can't get it. So if you're in the mode to be able to receive change, this is for somebody. Everybody talking about, I want to change, I want to do this, I want to do... You got to make up in your mind you want to change first.
This is very true.
You can talk about change all day long, but until you are ready to make that move, to do something differently than what you're doing, stop fooling yourself. It's time to change.
It is time for change, it really is.
It's time.
Still getting nowhere.
No, God didn't call lazy people.
No, he didn't.
I'm sorry. We still wait. He's still waiting on some of us to bust a move. Yes, indeed. But those who want.
Hmm. If you would allow me, because I don't want.
Yes. To oh no, please.
I want to say I'd like to give a shout out to the group United.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, I don't want to get in no trouble either, but.
Why not? I get in trouble a lot, so go ahead.
Get trouble all the time.
I'm trying not to say that. That's your confession, though. I just said I have gotten in trouble. My producer will probably say yes. He's shaking his head now.
In agreement, huh?
With you. Not with me, but with you. He's in agreement with you. But go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Please, I forgot about United. I was just so busy talking about Betty. So please, United, y'all forgive me. I love y'all too, because without United, you know, Betty by herself don't, you know what I'm saying? She out there on stage by herself. So let me be quiet. Go ahead, Miss Betty. Go ahead.
No, I just want to give a quick shout out to the group United. I love them.
Oh, yeah. I do too.
Awesome people.
Yeah.
I love them, and they're, you have to know them. They're just family to me. I call them family.
Come on. I know one thing. They're very protective of you. Don't think y'all going to bum rush the stage. That's not going to happen. People will come from the left and right talking about security. Here they come. Woo! She got her own personal SWAT team. So don't think y'all going to bum rush the stage to get that little love from Sister Hawkins. Let me help y'all. That's not going to happen. Don't do it. Your feelings and body may get you in trouble. So I want to help y'all. Don't bum rush the stage, because she got a SWAT team. They don't play. Them brothers don't play. They don't play. So don't do it. Don't do it. They are, and they're so supportive of you. And especially if y'all are related in any kind of way, to have that type of love displayed on a continual basis. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's what God has joined together.
One of them is in Texas. He moved to Texas, but yesterday he called just.
Oh,
you don't find that.
No. See, they missed that mouth. I just want to help you. They missed the mouth. Yes, indeed. It's just not easy without hearing that voice. That voice. Oh, the voice of God. And laughter is good. For those of you who are thinking that you turned into a sideshow or something that is not church-like or not Christian enough for you, I'm not going to apologize. Laughter is good. It heals the soul, the mind, the body. It is a regulator. It helps you to, it actually enables you to learn better if you're in an environment that you're feeling good about yourself. Amen? It really does. So I'm glad you gave a shout out, because we almost missed it. And I don't want them, when I come down, hey, I want to give a shout out to everybody, all them, mama them, all y'all them there, all y'alls, everybody that's in Moreau, Louisiana. I will be there in June. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hey, I felt the anointing on that right there. I am coming to Monroe. I don't know the address, but I will shout it out. And when I come, don't be looking at me strange, because I will be praising God in bare feet. So don't get your feelings offended, because I don't want to tear up no shoes. I want to enjoy God and everything he has, because I am expecting. They're going to be off. Now I'm going to wear them in the church. But when the music going on, I'm taking them off. Just in case y'all never seen nothing like that, I just want to let you know. with my new socks on. I'm going to have some socks. But we're going to be dancing for Jesus. We're going to bust the move for the Lord. We're going to give him glory and honor and all that belongs unto him. Because he deserved the glory. Hey, yes. I love me some Jesus, and I love to let the world know I am not ashamed of this gospel. You understand?
I am not either.
It's such a, oh man, you don't want to stir it up, because I'm happy, glad, just thinking about how good God is being to this little country girl. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You know what they say, look what the Lord has done, and it's marvelous. In the sight. It's marvelous. You have had a vast journey of experiences, and I'm going to allow you like 3 minutes to speak to somebody who feels that God, you stated earlier, that maybe has forgotten them. Maybe they're so depressed that they're thinking about suicide. I cast that spirit out right now, and I bind that and fill the void with life and joy and expectations. But sometimes you can be hit so hard, and it seems like nobody is hearing you, seems like you don't know what to do. But I want you to give them that lifeline that was given to you after you had to bury your own child, because you could have just threw in the towel right then and there and walked away from God. But you didn't. I thank God that you didn't. Could you offer them some encouraging words? Not just words that sounds good, but speak from the heart, from where you've been, to take that person, to rise them up, to resurrect them from the pain of yesterday or today, please.
First of all, I thank God for the journey that I've been on. And I thank God for the journey that I'm on and the journey that is ahead of me. And I say ahead of me because I need to express to you that there is a journey ahead of you. That's why you can't get caught up in where you are now. Now is a temporary place. It's a temporary situation. And whatever you're going through, just remember that. It's just temporary. When I was dealing with the death of my daughter, if I can just really be honest.
Please.
That was the most awful place I had ever been in. That was an awful. I have never experienced hurt like that before. My heart was hurting, so I had to go to the hospital because I thought I was having a heart attack. And they say, you just have a broken heart. But now, God is bringing me through that. I'm going through. The word is through. You're not in. I'm going through. That means I won't be in that place always. You won't be in the place that you're in always. If people walk out on you, let them walk out. That's the end of the chapter for them. God has some new people ahead. He's going to give you new friends. He's going to give you new relationships. He's going to give you... Because everything is going to be a new... And if I can get you to grasp that, don't get caught up in the now. But I was going through a tough time. But the first thing is know the word. You have to read the word and know the word. You can't live what you don't know. And if
Jesus.
I had not been given a great foundation as a child, my parents brought me up. My mama made sure I knew the word of God and I was in that church. And some people say drugs. I felt like I was on drugs, because I was drug everywhere. Sunday school, Bible study, BTU, choir rehearsal, you name it, we were drugs. And so, but that was the foundation, because God was up to something all the time. And so, I'm just telling you, whatever you're going through, if you're in depression, contemplating suicide, you just need to be inspired, because it's something you want to do, and you need inspiration. Encourage, you just need to be encouraged. If you're a child, adult, young adult, it doesn't matter. God is with you in your struggle.
Mm-hmm.
And he will never leave you, and he won't forsake you. And so that's why I have these certain songs, because these songs will be around when I'm not around.
Say that.
And they'll feel the flame to inspire people,
mm-hmm.
and encourage people.
Mm-hmm.
Don't give up. Don't throw in the towel, because that's the trick of the enemy. To get you to give up.
Mm.
God has a plan for your life. God has a plan for each and every one of us.
Yes.
And that's what I want you to know. Do not give up.
My God. Amen, sister. Amen. So powerful. Your words were so powerful because there's the anointing behind it. It's the experience. Like you said, I'm not telling you about something I heard. I'm telling you from what I know. And that, as my mother would say, that store-bought experience outweighs anything, any book, any textbook that you could learn in any college. Yes. I thank God for you, woman of God. I am just happy, glad. I mean, just like, whoa, just, I have really thoroughly enjoyed myself with you today. I am so ecstatic that you were with us today and that you had the opportunity to be with me. And we shall meet again. And next time, we're going to do... I want United to be with you, and we're gonna book that back room, and we're just gonna have a celebration party. How about that?
Amen. That works. They'll love
it. All right, we're gonna get together. I'm gonna have my people call your people, and we're gonna people this out, and just make it a joyful a celebration hour. Just flowing, just allowing the Holy Ghost to do, say whatever. I perceive that we could do that and just have a really good time.
Yeah, that works. And woman of God, I wanted to take a moment to say to you, I thank you for having me on.
Oh.
Chosen anyone, I appreciate that, and I speak God's blessings up on your life. Blessings will come in and just overtake you and your family.
Thank you.
I
received that. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. We have about, 2 minutes? 2 minutes? Okay. Well, you know, I hate to end it up because if I start talking, you start talking, time for another show. But you definitely gave me some... just saying. You just give me some great ideas for some new shows, and we might have to play a game, figure out, do like the wedding game. I'm serious about that. I can really see that in my mind. The relationship game. That's what we're gonna call it. Were you called or you just showed up and went? You know, there's a big difference. I gotta be careful with that. We might end some marriages. That's not my job. I'm supposed to be celebrating marriages, not creating divorces. So anyway, I'm glad I made you laugh. Amen. Laughter is good. But listen. Amen. Listen, everybody under the sound of my voice, I just want to thank God for you today. You guys could have tuned in anybody else. You could have been doing anything else, but you chose to listen to Rise Again with my special guest and my new friend, Minister Betty Hawkins and United. And I just thank God for her and her ministry of music. You will find her on Betty Hawkins and United on the YouTube. We talked about You're All I Need, You Are. What was the other one I missed? It's another title.
Coming.
Yeah, I need y'all to just go on, pull it up, and get ready to cry, shout, whatever it is you need to do, whatever type of release you need to get it and give God the glory for this vessel that he's choosing to anoint us with power and grace. Again, I thank you, my sister. You're such a blessing. I'm going to say goodbye to you on the phone, but I'm going to text you with the information that you'll need for this show. And I love you and I appreciate you. And may God continue to bless you and your group 1,000 times more. This is Pastor Sadie Thompson of He Is Risen World Outreach Ministries. And I want to let you know that Jesus Christ is Lord. He loves you and I love you. And there's not a thing that you can do about that. Listen. Bishop Albert Ray Thompson will have his Rise Again show audience on Wednesday, at 2 p.m. You don't want to miss it. Wednesday at 2 p.m. I don't know who his special guest is, but listen, you don't.